So in the yesterday's class, we started with edge detection and we have seen different gradient operators. So under that, we studied Robert operator, then Privet and Sobel operator. In today's class, we are going to study this Marr-Hilderite edge detector, also known as LOG operator. And today's lecture is going to be very short because today we'll be completing two practicals also. So I will share the video demonstrating how to complete these two tasks, that is edge detection using Privet, Sobel and Laplacian of Gaussian operator, and second one is data compression using Huffman coding. So by evening I will share that video, and let us keep the deadline of these two practicals as next Saturday, so that is 5th December. Okay, so I will upload the activities for these two practicals on Moodle. So let us see what is LOG operator. Okay, so before that we will discuss the drawbacks of using the Laplacian alone. So generally this Laplacian is not used in its original form. Why? Because as we have seen in the yesterday's class, we have discussed this diagram. So in the first column we have the images, this is image and this is the corresponding intensity profile of that, and we have introduced the noise for these three images, and this is the first order derivative and this is second order derivative, and Laplacian is nothing but the second order derivative, and actually we are interested in this zero crossing property of the Laplacian, this second order derivative. But as this image is having very low noise, see the intensity profile of this second order derivative. Now these two spikes are not clearly visible, okay, and thereby we cannot utilize that zero crossing property. That means this Laplacian is very sensitive to the noise, okay. So that's why we cannot use the Laplacian alone, okay, in its original form. So it is unacceptably sensitive to the noise. The magnitude of Laplacian produces the double edges that we have discussed Tuesday's lecture. Okay, it produces the double edges, right? But why we are interested in Laplacian? Because of these two properties. It has the zero crossing property, okay, which can be used to determine the edge location. And second one is it establishes whether a pixel is on the dark side or the light side of the edge. How? So let me show you this image. So now this, from this to this we have an edge. Now all the pixels lying between this range are known as the edge pixels. As we have seen, we don't get the ideal edge, right? We generally get the ramp edges, right? Okay, so there will be multiple edge pixels lying in that range. Okay, so whether the edge pixel is on the dark side of the edge or the light side of the edge can be determined from the sign of these spikes. If the sign of that spike is positive, that means that edge pixel is lying on the darker side of the edge, and if the sign is negative, that means that edge pixel is lying on the brighter side of the edge. Okay, so we want to utilize that property also. That's why we are interested in Laplacian. Now these two scientists stated that an operator used for the edge detection should have two salient features. Okay, so the operators used for the edge detection should follow these two properties. That means it should be differential operator capable of computing a digital approximation of the first order or second order derivative. That means they should find the first order or second order derivative, okay, and it should be capable of being tuned to act at any desired scale, so that large operators can be used to detect the blurry edges and small operators to detect the sharply focused fine details. Okay, so what is the meaning of this second point? So we have studied Privet and Sobel operators. Now their size is fixed, their size is 3 by 3, right? Now we cannot scale up these operators, okay, but what is the meaning of this statement? Your operator, that is edge detection operator, should be scalable. That means we should get a large operator in order to find the blurry edges. The blurry edges has a lower slope. We have seen that, right? And when we have a sharp edge, we have a this kind of a profile, right? So we should have a large operator to detect the blurry edges and small operator to detect the sharply focused fine details. Okay, so these two properties should be satisfied by the edge detector operator. That is the saying of these two scientists. Okay, and what they have observed, the filter, which is, what is this delta square, is what? It is a Laplacian, right? Laplacian of Gaussian. This G represents Gaussian, fulfills this condition. That is their observation. Okay, so what we have to do? First we have to find the Gaussian image. That means we have to apply the Gaussian low pass filter. So we have studied this Gaussian low pass filter when we are discuss low pass filtering in frequency domain, right? So first we have to apply the Gaussian low pass filter, and followed by we have to apply the Laplacian operator on that. Okay, so this is the equation for 2D Gaussian function, where sigma represent the standard deviation. So we have to set the parameter of sigma, okay, and then we have to find the Laplacian of this Gaussian image. Okay, so if you put the value of this g of x in this equation, and Laplacian is nothing but the second order derivative, right? Okay, so if you find this partial second order derivative with respect to x and with respect to y, we'll get this final equation. Okay, so this expression is known as a Laplacian of Gaussian. Why it is named Laplacian of Gaussian? Because we are finding first the Gaussian, okay, and then Laplacian of that. Okay, so this detector is also known as a LOG operator. Okay, and if we plot this equation, we get this intensity profile. Okay, so this is a 3D plot of that LOG. Okay, and as you can see, we get this hat like structure. Okay, and if we see the cross section of that, 2D cross section of that, we can see this function has zero crossing property. Okay, and this represent a 5x5 kernel approximation of this shape. Okay, so this is the approximation of this shape. Okay, as you can see, in the middle we have the highest value representing this peak, and then for this valley we are having a negative values surrounding that higher value. Okay, and for the outer region we should have a zero, so we are having a zero in the outer regions. Okay, so now if we scale this graph, this intensity profile, we can get a mask of different size. That means we are achieving this scalable property. Okay, and as we are finding the Laplacian, so we are satisfying the first property also. Okay, so in this way we can obtain this LOG mask. Okay, this Laplacian of Gaussian is sometimes also called as Mexican hat function. Okay, so for the same mask we have three names. It is known as Mark Hildred edge operator. It is also known as the LOG operator and Mexican hat function. Okay, so they may ask you the question using any name. Okay, so remember these three names. It can be also computed by what we have done at the first step. We have to apply the Gaussian mask followed by the Laplacian mask. Okay, so we can compute the same first by smoothing using the Gaussian low pass filter and followed by application of the Laplacian mask. Okay, now in order to summarize, there are two fundamental ideas behind the selection of this operator. First, why we have chosen this Gaussian? Because Laplacian was sensitive to the noise, right? So by applying the low pass filter, we are reducing the noise. Okay, so we are reducing the intensity structure including the noise. Then we can easily apply the Laplacian and thereby utilizing its zero crossing property. Okay, so that is the main idea behind using this LOG operator, and this is the result. Okay, so this is our original image, and this is after applying the Gaussian followed by the Laplacian, and then we have to apply the thresholding operation. Okay, so this is with I think zero value. Yes, using the threshold of zero. Okay, so we are getting very noise. Okay, then we have increased the threshold value. It is 4% of the maximum value. So if the maximum value intensity value is 100, the threshold is kept as a 96. Okay, and you can see we are getting this edge image. Okay, so now you can see the discontinuity along the edge. So we can apply some algorithm to join the edge also. Okay, so this is how LOG works. In the next class we are going to study this canny edge detector. So I will share the video demonstrating how to achieve these two tasks, that is edge detection and data compression. And let me show you the function that I am going to use. For finding the edge, we have edge function in MATLAB. Okay, and there we have to provide the method. Okay, so various method defined in this functions are Sobel, Privet, Roberts, LOG and canny. Okay, so we can use any of this. We have studied all the functions, and one more function is there. Yes, we have a f special function. We have already used this function, so we can see, we can create our own filter, and then we can use im filter function. Here they have created a filter using f special, and then we can use the im filter to apply that mask. Okay, so we can create an average function for doing the blurring. Then we can create a Gaussian also. Okay, then Laplacian, LOG, Privet and Sobel. Okay, so f special, if you say f special Privet, it will return this mask. Okay, then if you say f special Sobel, we'll get this mask. Okay, so we can achieve, we can find the edge either by using f special followed by im filter, or we can directly use this edge function. Okay, so I will demonstrate that. Okay, so please mark your attendance. Any doubt?